Hey guys, Tom here from FXhome, and welcome to our very first Blender to HitFilm Masterclass. This series is perfect for those familiar with visual effects and wanting to learn 3D, as well as filmmakers wanting production value for their shorts. We've just come back from a shoot where we were struggling to find the ideal location. I have this shot, this handsome actor standing around, but the director originally pictured this bad guy hideout to have a stack of cargo containers, and our location only had a couple to reference. So we'll be extending this scene using 3D models that we'll be making. I myself am no Blender guru, so we'll be taking things slow and learning things step by step to work towards our first 3D model. Starting off by getting to know the interface, adding textures, enhancing the detail, then jumping into HitFilm for our compositing. Finally looking at next steps in your Blender learning. First, let's jump into Blender and see what we're going to be working with. At the time of this video, we are working in version 2.82. If you haven't got Blender installed already, don't worry, the link is down in the description. Let's get started. Once open, you'll be presented with a scene containing a light, camera, and cube. This is the default loadup and will often be deleted immediately for a fresh start. But let's keep this for now. We're going to be moving around a lot, so let's get used to our navigation. This main window is the viewer. In here, we can zoom in by scrolling the mouse wheel, middle mouse click to activate the rotation, or middle mouse click and shift to move left, right, up and down. This also comes with some preset views to help during modeling. You can activate these by using the numbers on the number pad. 1, 3, and 7 are the key ones to use. An easy way to remember this is to imagine as if the model had been unfolded. 1 is your front view, 3 is your side, and 7 the top view. The keys in between slowly rotate the viewer, while 0 activates the camera view. The panel in the top right corner is your scene layout. This presents all the items within your setup. You can select each item from here or open them up to review any modifications made. Below this is the property panel. Think of them as a list of effects like we have in HitFilm. Here you can change the render engine, output settings, add modifiers and physics to our scene for visual effects. But that may be for another time, so be sure to subscribe not to miss anything we cover in future. The one thing we will be looking into over this course is the materials tab, this little pink icon. Top left of your viewer, you'll notice this tab that reads Object Mode. This is the default mode available for all object types as it's dedicated to object data block editing. That's position, rotation, and scale. If you select the cube and hit Tab, this will switch us over to the Edit Mode. In here, we'll be able to adjust the mesh's structure, which is broken down into 3 sections. More on them later. We'll be working in here a lot and then switching over to Object Mode for viewing. We do this as assets should not be added while in edit mode unless designed to be joined. To get out of edit mode, we hit Tab. Blender also provides a number of different editors for displaying and modifying different aspects of data. This can be changed by entering this tab and selecting the value you want. If you go to the left of this tab, you should get this crosshair. If you click and drag this in a direction, a new window will be revealed. And in these, you can set the viewer to an alternative editor type. A very useful feature when working with textures. To remove these windows, simply click and hold on the viewer you'd like to keep and move it over till an arrow is revealed. Then release. Windows can only go into one another, so no more than one at a time can be added or removed. Now we have the UI and essentials covered, let's take a look at the model itself. While in object mode, select the cube. We can move this around freely by pressing G on the keyboard. Rotations can be made with R and scale with S. To keep things on an axis, however, press the function you're altering, followed by an axis letter, X, Y, or Z, as seen from the axis gizmo. Yes, that's actually what it's called. These will now be locked into one dimension of movement. The same can be done with elements of your model. Let's enter the edit mode by pressing Tab on the keyboard. This is where we'll be altering the object itself, by using the different types of selection we mentioned earlier. Up here, beside the edit tab, are 3 types of selection: vertex, the points of the model, edges, the cuts between faces, and the faces themselves, the plane that makes the surface of the model. You can use the scale, rotation, and move functions on these as you would the model in object mode. We'll be going through these tools in future videos as and when we use them. The last thing to review is the shading model. Jump back into object mode by hitting Tab, then press Z to bring up the shading options. These 4 are what will be used to examine our model, starting off with the current state, solid. This gives a basic, flat representation of the object we're making. Material Preview provides a fast approximation of the applied material. Wireframe reveals a mesh of lines representing the edges of faces and surfaces. Finally, an accurate representation can be seen while using Rendered. This will alter depending on the selected render engine, but will always be lit with visible scene lights. There's a lot more Blender to see, but you've made your first steps in learning 3D. That's it for the user interface. If you hop over to our other tutorials, we'll use what we've learned today to start shaping and texturing our first 3D model. Be sure to subscribe and ring the bell icon to avoid missing out any of these masterclass tutorials. And we'll see you in the next tutorial.